Si ama kama kuna lolote la kusema kuendana na kile ambacho tunakizungumzia hapa, nambari zetu ni zile zile. Of course, kama ni kwenye WhatsApp ama ujumbe ule wa kawaida tu, ni kwenye 0721 105 105, 0721 105 105. Are we together? Na kama ni kwa the short code, that is free of charge, ni 23814 23814. Ukiweka ujumbe hapo, kila kitu kitakuwa ni shwari kabisa. Lakini pia kumbuka ni kwamba tuko live kwenye Facebook na tuko live kwenye YouTube channel ya MBC TV Official, and of course hapo kwa comment section unaweza ukaweka ujumbe wako hapo, na mimi hapa nitakuwa na usoma kwa njia ile safi kabisa. Kwa hiyo sasa hivi zimekatika dakika 39 baada ya saa 4, all the way mpaka saa 6 tuko tutazungumzia masuala haya ya jinsi ya kuchagua benki ambayo utaweza kuweka pesa zako. Na katika wakati mmoja pia tutakuwa tunaangalia swala la online banks, are they even safe? You know, kuna mambo mengi sana ambayo tutakuwa tunatackle hapa, and everything is going to be okay right now. Mgeni ambaye niko naye hapa, niko naye kwa mara ya kwanza ndani ya kipindi hiki cha Financial Monday, na hata kwenye Rausho sidhani nimemuona tena, naona kana kwamba namuona kwa mara ya kwanza kabisa, na anafahamika kama Petronila Wanjiko. Now, Petronila Wanjiko ni banker na ni meneja wa tawi la benki ya UBA, tawi la Nakuru. Ndiye tuko naye hapa, ndivyo akaweze kukueleza na kufafanua kwa undani masuala yote ambayo tunayazungumzia hapa, and I believe ya kwamba utaweza kusaidika kwa njia iliyokubwa kabisa. Ladies and gentlemen, Petronila Wanjiko in the building, ndani ya the Financial Monday.
Yes.
Good morning.
Morning.
Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
You good?
Yes, I'm good.
How are you?
Not bad, and you?
Okay, I'm fine, thank the Lord. Sisi unajua tuliraukia huko na mapema sana.
Yes.
Tayari tumefanya kipindi kimoja, sasa tuko kwenye hiki kingine, and we are happy to have you.
Thank you.
Nafikiri kwamba hujakuwa hapo wakati mwingine?
No, it's my first time.
It's your first time?
Yes.
So 2024 for you is a defining year, and we thank the Lord.
Amen to
How
that.
How is UBA?
Not bad. UBA is very, very fine.
Okay.
We are having good business. We are having good environment for business,
yeah,
and we are very happy to be invited here.
That's amazing.
Yes.
Now you are the branch manager.
Yes.
Nakuru branch.
Yes.
Maybe kwa kugusia tu kwa UU.
Yes.
Branch manager kazi yake ni gani sana sana?
Branch manager kazi yake haswa ni kuwa msimamizi wa hiyo branch.
Uh-huh.
Unasimamia branch.
Yeah.
Lakini cha maana ni kuwa you work together with your staff, you help your staff to manage the customers who bank in that branch.
Mm.
So the operations kwa banki, kuna operations team na business team.
Mm-hmm.
So you are in charge of both teams.
Yes.
Yes. The operations inamaanisha kukuja kuweka pesa, kutoa, that's the operation bit.
Mm-hmm.
Kufungua accounts, kutaka kuangaliliwa loan account statements.
Yeah.
That's the operations part.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have the business part.
Okay.
Sasa sisi sana sana branch manager utapata tunaegemea saidia business, because kuna pia mwenye ako chini yangu anaitwa operations manager, mwenye anasimamia sasa the operations part.
Yes.
Yes, but the business part is now where tunatoka nje.
Mm-hmm.
Kazi ya bank is squeezy, it's very competitive. You don't wait for the customers.
Mm.
You go look for the customers.
Mm.
So what we do with my sales team, it's go look for these customers.
Okay.
Then we sit down and we understand huyu customer anafaa kusaidiwa na njia gani.
Okay.
So we work together with my team.
Yeah.
As much as they are reporting to me, I'm supposed to be leading them.
Yeah.
So it's a more of a leading position.
Okay.
Yes.
So unajua tulikuwa tunajua ukisikia manager,
mm-hmm,
you already picture ako kwenye ofisi na kiti ambacho kinazunguka.
Anazunguka na maji.
Na bairo
maji baridi. Yeah.
Akiulizanga hizo vitu mlipeana. Kumbe wakati mwingine mpaka kutoka kule nje kukutana na wateja.
Yes, yes.
Siku hizi hakuna kusubiri mteja aje, wewe ndio unamwendea.
Unamwendea penye yako.
Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
And this is going to be a very, very wonderful conversation with you right here.
Yes.
Maanake tunajua kwamba kando na, you know, kuna wiri katika sekta zingine za kimaisha pia.
Mm-hmm.
Katika swala la kifedha it's very, very key.
Yes.
And by the way, katika masuala ya pesa ndio pia kwa kiwango kikubwa yanadetermine shughuli zingine za mtu zitakuwa kwa njia
gani.
Exactly.
Yes.
Hata sasa hivi katika nchi kama hii unasikia watu wote wakiongea, wanasema uchumi. Wanaposema uchumi, just know it's all about money.
Yes.
You know, and because of that, we are having the right person to talk to us and everything is okay.
Yes.
Now, tunazungumza kuhusiana choosing a bank ambayo naweza nikaweka hela zangu kule,
yes,
kuhifadhi pesa zangu huko. But when you're talking about investing ama saving in a bank, mm-hmm, what are we really talking about? Yes. Now from a brand manager's perspective.
Yes.
Good.
Now that's a very good question.
Karibu.
Investing in a bank. Mm-hmm. So it depends also to take you back to who is investing. First, who is investing to the bank?
Mm-hmm.
Because we have various people.
Yes.
Utapata kuna mtu anafanya biashara, utapata kuna mtu ameemployiwa, huyo mtu ameajiriwa,
mm-hmm,
analipwa mshahara,
mm-hmm, huyo
mwingine anafanya biashara, huyo mwingine ako na pesa yake, amejenga manyumba zake, anataka kulipiwa rent hapo. So we have different people who want to invest in a bank.
Wewe mshahara,
yule
wa kufanya biashara, na kuna mwenye sasa amejenga, amewekeza,
ameshajiestablish, sasa amewekeza,
pesa zipite huko.
Exactly.
Oh.
Na kuna mwingine utapata pia ako na account za watoto wake, anataka kuakisave kwa account za hao watoto. Ndio ikifika huko mbeleni anaweza kuwa akitoa pesa hapo ya masomo ya vitu vingine kama hizo.
Yeah.
So investing in a bank inategemea ni nani anataka kuinvest.
Mm-hmm.
So nianze na wa kwanza, mwenye anafanya biashara. Mwenye anafanya biashara ikikuja investing in a bank, you will get these people, as much as they want to invest in a bank, ni mtu atakuwa akiweka akito, cause leo nimeuza kwa duka yangu,
yes,
nimekuja nime deposit pesa,
mm-hmm,
exactly,
mm-hmm,
so nitataka nitoe ile pesa niende ninunue bidhaa za kuuza the following day,
yes,
cause it's a demand and supply business,
yes.
So mtu kama huyo mwenye anawekeza kwa bank anafaa kuangalia nini akikuja kuwekeza kwa hiyo bank,
mm-hmm.
So you find most of the banks right now, they will come in to boost your business, not to give you money for startup.
Okay.
We want you to come up with an idea,
mm-hmm,
get some funds, you are saving somewhere.
On my own?
Yes.
Okay.
And then start. So when you start, you'll set a business, then it becomes successful.
Mm-hmm.
So I started hii biashara, na demand ilikuwa hivi na hivi. Then over time, I've been able to market myself. So the demand has gone up. So, mm-hmm, I need to up my supply.
Mm-hmm.
So you approach a bank, you want to increase your supply.
Mm-hmm.
Unaona, nimefungua maybe a beauty shop.
Mm-hmm.
I was doing sales hapa na pale. Then I've gotten traction. Watu wameanza kukuja wengi.
Mm-hmm.
So for this person, I would advise mtu kama huyu anafaa kuwekeza na banki, si kwa nyumba. Because, mm-hmm, ikifika hiyo wakati unataka kusaidiwa na banki, banka itaangalia pesa yenye ulikuwa unaweka kwa nyumba.
Sure.
How are you banking with us?
Mm-hmm.
Cause kutoka kwa hizi bankings ndio tunaweza establish profit margin, huyo mtu ni pesa ngapi.
Yeah.
What is the sales he's doing per day?
Mm-hmm.
What is he buying? Because you see, when you bank someone in business, hata wale watu wenye anauzia, you get, most of them are paying through that account. So you are able to tell wenye wananunua kwake na wenye pia ananunua mzigo kutoka kwake.
Because
akikuja kutoa, atatransfer pesa ama alipe invoice mahali.
So unaona tu.
Unaona venye. So you get, mm-hmm, to understand the business more.
Mm-hmm.
But this person who is
at home,
weka pesa nyumbani,
yeah,
I might not understand kwa siku anauza pesa ngapi. So hata akikuja kae kwa desk yangu anataka nimsaidie kuboost biashara, it will be a hard call to make a decision on funding that business.
Because I'm like a stranger.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, and the money, when the money passes through the account, you're able to tell a lot of things from that. Yani naweza kaa chini na hiyo statement yake, ni analyze, because a bank, it's not only kupeana pesa. We are also financial advisors.
Yeah.
Tuko na hiyo ujuzi, tumesomeshwa na banki, the experience of years we have in banking, we are able to tell this person and advise them,
mm-hmm,
on the way to go.
Yes.
So kazi si kupeana pesa peke yake. Wewe kuwekeza kwa bank, unafaa uwekeze kwa bank pia, you are given personalized relationship. Huu mtu anatembea kwa biashara yako na anaweza kuambia, so and so hapa na hapa, naona unafanya hivi 90 days credit na wewe unauziwa vitu na cash. Anza kufanya 30 days so that you're able to bridge the gap between wenye wananunua na wenye wanakuzia mzigo.
Mm, mm.
So we're able to kuwaelimisha.
Okay.
So a business person, it's very okay banking. It's very advisable, let,
yeah,
me say that.
Yeah.
To bank at, not at home, to bank with a bank.
It's crucial.
It's very crucial. Because, mm, once the business expands, unajua unafungua biashara ya expand.
Sure.
Sifungui niuze vitu tatu in a day.
Alafu funge.
Alafu nifunge. I expect business it a grow.
Okay.
Na venye business ina grow, you need support. You need,
right,
financial support.
Yeah.
So you approach a bank. Mimi nimeona biashara yangu, I need more stock of 500,000, a million, so that I'm able to meet my customers' demand.
Mm-hmm.
So the supply needs to be up. So,
okay,
when you come to the bank, we sit down. Customer anakuwa akiuza hivi, demand yake imepanda to this extent.
Mm.
So he's asking for an amount of 500,000. So we sit down and see hii 500 anaweza lipa kwa muda gani?
Yeah.
What is the amount that he can be able to pay? Because kwa loan haulipangi na stock. You pay with the profit margin.
Sure.
The profit you are making. Because the moment you start getting to your capital ama to your stock to pay a loan, that's not good business. So we always pay with the profit margin that you are making.
I'm getting. Okay.
So the only way we can be able even to tell that is you banking with the bank.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Because now you can be able to tell the transaction vile ambavyo zinaingia zikitoka. And also my reliability.
Okay. And also we are able to tell you. Unajua sasa hata ukikuja bank, once we visit, normally what we do, once you come to open an account with us, we have our sales team who will come to the ground. You just don't, these days you don't walk to the bank and open an account if you are a business person.
Mm-hmm.
You need to first introduce yourself and then say, I have a shop here and there. So I have a shop in Kiamunyi, I'm selling it's a hardware, I sell this and this and this. So there's a salesperson who will start the journey with you at that particular time.
Hmm.
So he comes to the ground, sees the hardware, what you are selling. So we start to understand your business. So from there, we also advise the salesperson we have given to you, ama the relationship manager we have given to you, wacha one ni record gani unaekanga. Kosi kuuza tu. You need to have some stocking, you need to know, hii mchanga, hii semiti nilinunua at 500 per bag, I'm selling at 550.
Mm-hmm.
So my profit margin is 50.
Mm-hmm.
If I sell 50 bags in a day, what have I made?
Oh.
So we are able to take them through that bookkeeping. Because
yeah.
when you come to the bank, this bookkeeping is the one that will assist us. Because we'll need to have some support document when we are appraising your facility.
Okay.
To ensure that we are not coming in and giving you so much money that we'll not be able to pay.
Mm.
You see?
And I wanted to ask, Mtu has an idea, brilliant idea.
Yes.
Minus money. And then akuje aseme, I'm so and so,
yes.
You know, I have this idea. And a lot of banks will be, okay, we'll help you start your business.
Uh-huh.
Why is it that that doesn't happen?
No, mostly at a bank, you get that might not happen, not unless you have started somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. Not unless you have started somewhere.
Okay.
But you get some banks, like the UBA bank, eh? We have some foundation now that can start. We have a very good foundation that whereby we train some of the interested SMEs, then we can be able to take them through the journey, and we even have some people winning a token to start the business.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to the real banking, we need to see you starting somewhere so that you can come and boost.
Because
you see, for the example, the loans that we have will need all these. Because you know, hata ukikuja tukae chini now, how will we tell how much you need to start the business?
Yeah.
And how will we tell, ukienda uanzisha hii biashara, who are your customers? Because you see the thing with a loan, eh? The moment mimi nimekupea pesa, utoke pale inje, uende uongwe, because you don't have experience in that business, you still pay me.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
How
utoke na pesa, uishe, unajua nilikuambia, sijui experience, we ukanipea tu pesa. You know, those are the things we are avoiding. Yeah?
Yeah.
At least now if you have gone in, hata kidogo, you know where to get the source, the items, where to sell to, you have a rough idea.
Yeah.
Then as a bank, we come in now and we make it a perfect idea.
Okay.
Yes.
There you go.
Yes.
Now, sasa mimi, I have an idea. Ama tusue, okay, uliko memaliza kunini, kuliko tunashugulika na katika.
Tuko kwa business, then we go to the other, to the other businesses.
All right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Alafu ulikuwa umesema a salaried person.
A salaried person, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Now moving to the salaried person, you get some of these people will want somewhere the salary. You will give an account to your employer.
Of course.
Penye atakuwa nakulipia mshahara.
Mm-hmm.
So you, when you're identifying a bank to invest in, what can you really get from this account?
Yeah.
So you get these people are opening a salary account.
Mm-hmm.
So what are the advantages of a salary account? Can I get a salary advance?
Mm-hmm.
Can I get a salary loan from this? So when you're identifying a bank as a salaried person, what are the benefits that comes with that salary passing through that bank?
Because
you see, we can never predict the future. I might be having a good salary, but something comes in between and I need my bank, the one that I chose, to come in and support me.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that you always get your salary at the end of the month, and we know how much you get.
Okay.
So can I come in, something has happened in between, and maybe your employer is not able to advance you the salary advance, can my bank advance me that? And which are some of the accounts that are good to open for salaries, and which are also the referrals that I can also bring other employees that we work with, so that in case there is a loan that we need co-guaranteeing, we are able to guarantee each other in these account.
Yeah.
So for salaried people, it's also good to go with a bank that will work with the journey with you on the employment side.
Mm.
Yes.
So anyone who is thinking of kuchukua hela zake ama pesa zake zipite kwenye benki,
yes,
there are those issues that must be considered.
Exactly.
Otherwise, kule mbele mtu anaweza kuwa na shock nyingi sana za kusema, I thought you do this and all.
Yes.
Do we have like the main things that apply for a salaried worker ama huyu mwenye ni a business person? The very main things that first of all mtu huwa anaangalia, you settle down na sema kwamba, okay, it is this bank, but now, now that nimeenda huko sasa wacha nianze kuangalia one, two. Do we have like zile ambazo zina apply generally kwa mtu salaried, kwa mtu mwenye biashara and all that?
Right now you'll get that most of the banks are offering that. Because you see with the competition out there, yes, it's how you are packaging your product to this client. And also I would say, before you open an account, walk into the entry desk, ama the customer service desk. Take your sweet time, engage the staff seated there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm willing to open an account. I want to open an account. Tell me what are the benefits.
Mm-hmm.
Most of these people know all the products of the bank. So sit with them, take your time. You don't just rush to open an account.
Mm-hmm.
Find out, I'm a salaried person. Kindly tell me, what are the products that you have under salaried people? I am an SME. MSME. MSME stands for medium, small and micro enterprises. So I am someone who falling under that category. Tell me, what are some of the products you have under fees?
Mm-hmm.
You get good explanation so that front there you don't get yourself na nilifungua account wapi huku. So at least when you're opening an account, you have all that information in your fingertips.
Yeah.
Then you sit down and make a decision on where you're opening that account. Because we can only relay information that we will act on. You don't entice a customer just to frustrate them later.
Mm.
We give you information of what we can offer, and then it's for you to decide, is that what I'm looking? Is that the investment I want to make?
Mm-hmm.
Is that the journey I want, my financial journey? Because making that decision will affect your financial situation later in life.
Sure.
So when you're making that decision, at least we give you what we are offering. Most of the banks will do that. Then it's you to choose.
Yeah.
Because you have a liberty of going to this and this bank and asking, what are you offering?
Yeah.
Then you sit down in Mukai Chini, maybe as salaried people in Kingdom, you're able to tell now we can really benefit from
this.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yes.
Majuzi, mm-hmm, unajua pia Kenya social media nayo imekuja na mambo mengi,
yes,
especially TikTok.
Mm-hmm.
Na kuna wakati ambapo nafikiria kwamba maybe a week ago too.
Yes.
Kumekuwa na watu sana without mentioning names,
yes,
ambao wamekuwa complain about sijui pesa ikatoka wapi, kaenda, mm-hmm, wapi and all that, sijui nikaenda nikauliza, sijui nikaambiwa nini. You know, is it possible for a bank, like nikileta do yangu nikiweka pale, that I'm guaranteed about the security of my money?
Yes.
Without later kuja kuambiwa ya kwamba sijui nini, ni kama kuna mtu alihack and all that.
Yes.
How does a bank make sure that hizo pesa ziko safe?
Okay. So what is happening, a lot of hacking happens. But what we do, most of the banks do, is to ensure that money does not get lost. And you find even those people who complained on TikTok, at the end of the day, they got their money.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, if you followed the few who had complained, they got their money.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Because I brought my money to you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way a money can be withdrawn from your account is through various channels.
Mm-hmm.
Either through digital platforms, that is mobile banking, you came, registered your phone. I want to be withdrawing money from my account with my phone.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can also withdraw money from the ATM. We give you an ATM card,
sure,
whereby you can go and withdraw money.
Mm-hmm.
The other platform, you can go over the counter and withdraw your money.
Yes.
So as a bank, you will get that most of the bank have CCTVs installed.
Sure.
So over the counter, in the ATM, we are able to tell whether you are the person who came and withdrew that money.
Or someone else.
So we are able to do that.
Yeah.
But you'll find that now banks have come up with very good programs that they are able to ensure that accounts are not hacked into.
Mm.
And we also get that this security is being offered through dual controls. Nobody can just withdraw money from your account.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the banks have been able to ensure that this doesn't happen.
Yeah.
The mistake you get is that someone receives a call. Unfortunately, this person thinks that it's a good person calling them. That's why we say, if you are receiving a call from this and this bank, this is the number that should be calling. Mm.
Strictly.
Strictly this number.
Okay.
Because you'll get someone else is being called by a different number. Bonyeza, finya hii, finya hii.
Tunaangalia sijui nini.
Tunaangalia nini. Ile pini ulikuwa umeweka, tunataka tubadilishe, unaweza rudia hiyo pin. You get you end up retyping your pin and your money is so good. I would say most of the time when money gets out of the account, it's people who are taking advantage of these people. So when you put your money in the bank, there's nobody who should call you and tell you press and press and press. No. Your money is saved in the bank. If you want anything, that's why I'm saying when you're opening an account, there is a person, a representative, who is now in charge of your account. We allocate you a relationship manager.
All right.
Who we share your number with. Huyu anaitwa Sarah. This is her phone number. She's the one who will be taking you through any challenges in your account.
Okay.
And maybe that staff maybe leaves the bank because it happens. We are able to tell you so and so left. And now we are introducing you to the new
person
who comes to visit you, or you set up a meeting where you talk.
Okay.
And these are their number. This should be the only number that calls you.
All right.
And we also have a customer service number for the bank that we always share in all our platforms. So those are the various numbers that you should call, because most of the time pesa inapotea juu ya watu.
So that means hii ya nimepigiwa simu na mtu labda sasa nimewekeza na UBA and then nimepigiwa na mtu ambaye nambari si ya UBA ameniambia finya hapa tunataka finya hii alafu nini ala and then pesa imeenda. How does that happen? Mnaweza nirudishia?
Hiyo ni kama wewe umetoa. Hiyo ni kama wewe umeithdraw.
Kwa nini ndio
nime authorize? Wewe ndio umeauthorize. Wewe ndio umeauthorize. Umepeana pin, umepeana nini, umebonyeza. Kwa nini ulikuwa unabonyeza in the first place? Usibonyeze.
Kuna fear ni nyinyi. And also they have, you know, kumekuwa na allegations out there.
Yes.
You know, at 1 minute. Oh, ni a break. Ni nataka kunipe depression kwa hiyo. Kumekuwa na allegations sometimes.
Yes.
Unasikia watu wanasema, you know, at sometimes if you see such things happening, at they are insiders. Kuna watu ndani ya huko wanasoma your account, wanajua. Hata kuna wakati kumekuwa na allegations kwamba that there are some people you'll go withdraw some amount of money, but wako na watu nje wanamwambia huyo mwenye ameingia ametoa hii na hii, unafuata and all that. Could such a thing happen? And if such thing happen or can happen, how can a bank make sure kwamba wale watu ambao wanafanya kazi kule ndani ni watu waaminifu? Hilo utatujibu tukitoka wapi?
Break. Sawa sawa.
Is that okay?
That's okay.
There
sir.
You go. Usiende mbali, tunarudi katika muda usiokuwa mrefu. Tukua naye Petronila Wanjiko ambaye ni meneja wa tawi la Nakuru benki ya UBA. Don't go too far.
MBCI Television, transforming lives. Throw 321 or call 0725-000-222.
Buda, unaonaje hii moti? Buda iko fiti mbaya. Lakini sulisema uwezi nunua dinga before ujenge. Sasa utaipaka wapi?
Ah, nitaipaka huku tu. Mimi nishandoa plot hadi naanza kujenga.
Wa? Buda, hebu nichanue.
Welcome to the Delight Nakuru, brought to you by Username Investments. Perfect for your dream home, investment for holiday home, going only for 799,000 shillings for an eighth of an acre. There's borehole water, estate gate, graded access roads, electricity and proximity to modern high-end schools, hospitals and other social amenities. SMS Nakuru to 20321 or call 0725-000-222.
Apostle Dan at 9 a.m. Don't miss this life-transforming occasion. See you there.
Kilimo ni uti wa mgongo katika uchumi wa kitaifa. Akili Shambani inakufunza mbinu mbalimbali za kilimo cha mimea na ufugaji. Tunavuka milima na mabonde kukuelimisha mengi kuhusu ubunifu na teknolojia katika kilimo. Yote tisa, kumi ni masoko na yoje.
Tunahusika na mkulima kutoka kwa shamba hadi sokoni.
Fahamu haya na mengine mengi kuhusu kilimo kwenye Akili Shambani kila Jumatano saa 1:30 usiku, ukiletewa nami Ina Eli Mlinga.
MBCI Television, transforming lives.
Yani kipindi kifupi sana cha mapumziko hicho, na tukiwa hapa tuko naye Petronila Wanjiko ambaye ni meneja wa tawi la Nakuru kutoka benki ya UBA, ambaye anatueleza mambo mengi ambayo unafaa kuangalia wewe wakati ambapo unawekeza ama unahifadhi pesa zako kwenye benki. Si kuweka tu, lazima pia unaweza kujiuliza. Mtu ananiambia amesikia UDA, mimi nimesema UBA. UDD, hiyo ni ya political party, and then we have UBA,
United Bank for
Africa. Yeah, usitoke alafu uende kwa ofisi za UDA kusema nimesikia mko na bank hapa. Now, tumetoka ama tumekwenda mapumzikoni nikiuliza hili swali la kuna wakati ambapo kumekuwa na allegations ya kwamba unasikia kwamba kuna uporaji umefanyika, na unasikia mtu anasema ya kwamba vile ambavyo ilionekana kwamba kulikuwa kuna watu ndani ya banki fulani ambao kwa njia moja au nyingine waliweza kushirikiana na watu walioko nje ndivyo waweze kumpora mteja. Na ikifika hapo mpaka unasikia mpaka watu wanauliza, kama hivyo ndivyo ilivyo, basi nitahakikishiwaje usalama wangu wakati ambapo nimewekeza katika banki fulani? Na tusemi benki moja, tunasema tu generally. So now my question to Petronila is this one. How do you ensure ya kwamba wale ambao wanafanya kazi kama ni pale kwa kupokezana hela na nini na nini ni watu ambao ni waaminifu, ya kwamba my information haiwezi kuwa leaked kwa a third party?
Okay,
yes please.
So a very good question. So when you are employing someone who will be handling cash, kitu ya kwanza sana tunafunza ni integrity. Integrity is very important. Then kuna document unafaa usign ya kusema kuwa it's an oath of secrecy. Watu wanaingianga kwa jeshi.
Yeah.
Yes. Also in the bank, you sign an oath of secrecy. That the information that you hold
about
in that bank,
individual,
yes, should not be shared. Na saa hii data protection is very important.
Very.
Very important.
Sure.
And there's a new rule that you just can't share someone's data. You can easily find yourself in trouble, both as a bank, both as an individual. So what we do as leaders is also we ensure that we take our staff monthly, weekly basis training on integrity. Why do we want people to be okay with what they're dealing with? By the way, unaambiangu kuwa tela, pesa inafaa kuwa maua. You should not be seeing it as money. Chaanza kuona ni pesa.
Utakuwa tempted.
Exactly. So we see it and see it as papers. When we are dealing with that money, it's not our money.
So that
it's
remove our attachment.
Yes,
now.
Attachment from that money. Ah. This is the customer's money.
Yeah.
Our very good customer. And the reason you're employed there, the reason you're being able to feed your family is because of those customers. So messing a customer is something we teach to these people. Should be the last. That's why when you sign an oath of secrecy, if something is gone out there, the bank can sue you as an individual. Because you signed that. You committed that mimi mumenipea kazi. I swear I will not share this and this and this. I will not collide with people to do this and this. So we really try that. And as you heard, there are allegations. It might happen. But if you have these things in place, you can easily hold that person responsible. If the right investigations have been done and the right things have been proved, this and this happened.
Not speculations.
Not speculations, not allegations. Because we really find that these people have been really trained. The bank are using a lot of expenses to train these people on integrity. So I can say banks have really tried to get, not unless kuna wale wenye mutu ni kuzaliwa akiwa kitu fishi, but bank has really installed this good discipline. We have signed all of us. Not only the person who is handling the cash.
Mpaka wewe kama branch
manager. Mpaka wewe kama branch manager. Even head of department up there. Everybody working for a bank institution or any institution that handles customer information should be able to sign that oath of secrecy.
Okay.
Yes.
So that in case something happens, na mtu ijulikane kwamba alikwenda against whatever you sign.
You are the person who is liable.
Now
not
the law
bank.
There in a law
comes in
squarely.
Exactly.
Now I want to ask you something about loans, but before I do so, wacha tuangalie siri ya mafanikio na kama vile ambavyo mtazamaji nilikuwa nimekueleza. And I love this conversation and I think we'll call you again and again.
Thank you. I'll come.
Tumekualika hata kabla hatujamaliza. So, tupate siri ya mafanikio na ukosefu wa nidhamu, personal discipline, madhara yake, my friend, ndo haya. Awamu hii ndani ya siri ya mafanikio tunaangazia matokeo ya ukosefu wa nidhamu. Ukosefu wa nidhamu unaweza kusababisha kutofaulu katika nyanja mbalimbali za maisha. Kwa mfano, bila nidhamu, watu binafsi wanaweza kuhangaika kudumisha udhabiti katika matendo yao na hivyo kusababisha tabia na matokeo mabaya. Nidhamu huwasaidia watu binafsi kuyapa kipaumbele malengo yao, na bila hiyo mtu anaweza kukengeushwa kwa urahisi na kupoteza mwelekeo wa kile kinachohitaji kufikiwa. Ukosefu wa nidhamu mara nyingi husababisha kuahirisha, ambapo kazi huchelewa au kutokamilika kwa wakati na hivyo kusababisha kukosa fursa na miradi kutokamilika. Nidhamu ni muhimu katika kudhibiti muda ipasavyo. Bila hivyo, muda unaweza kupotea kwa urahisi kwenye shughuli zisizo muhimu na kusababisha ukosefu wa maendeleo katika maeneo muhimu. Nidhamu ni muhimu katika kukuza maadili thabiti ya kazi. Bila hivyo, watu mmoja mmoja wanaweza kukosa msukumo unaohitajika ili kuweka jitihada zinazohitajika katika kufanikiwa. Ukosefu wa nidhamu unaweza kupelekea mtu kushindwa kudhibiti msukumo na kusababisha tabia zisizofaa, matumizi ya fedha kupita kiasi, kula kupita kiasi na tabia zingine mbaya. Bila nidhamu, watu binafsi wanaweza kupuuza fursa za ukuaji, kujifunza na maendeleo kwa sababu ya ukosefu wa kujitolea na udhabiti. Ukosefu wa nidhamu unaweza pia kuathiri mahusiano baina ya watu, huenda ukasababisha kutotegemewa, kutofautiana na ukosefu wa ufuatiliaji na kusababisha matatizo na kuvunjika kwa mahusiano. Kutokuwa na nidhamu katika masuala ya fedha kunaweza kusababisha matumizi makubwa ya fedha, mrundikano wa madeni na kukosa akiba na hatimaye kusababisha kuyumba kifedha. Ukosefu wa nidhamu katika mazoea yanayohusiana na afya kama vile mazoezi, lishe na kulala kunaweza kusababisha matokeo mabaya ya afya ya mwili na akili na kuathiri ustawi wa jumla na ubora wa maisha. Kwa muhtasari, nidhamu ni muhimu kwa mafanikio katika nyanja zote za maisha kwani hutoa muundo, udhabiti na motisha unaohitajika kufikia malengo, kufanya maendeleo na kuishi maisha ya kuridhisha na yenye tija. Ni ndani ya siri ya mafanikio na tumeelewana naamini.
Personal discipline. If you lack that, then in this life utakuwa na shida kubwa. Hata wale watu wengine ambao wameonekana kana kwamba kwa njia moja au nyingine wamefanikiwa lakini wanakosa nidhamu, mwisho wa maisha yao huwa kuna shida kubwa. Hata wengine umesikia mambo mengine mpaka unauliza ilifanyikaje? Huyu ni mtu ambaye anaonekana yuko na hela zake. Kitu ambacho alikosa, alikuwa na hela ndio kwenye banki lakini nidhamu, akaunti yake ya nidhamu ilikuwa zero. So unasikia mtu amefanya kitu, you end up in jail, mwingine unafanya kitu, unafilisisha biashara zako zote, mwingine unafanya kitu, yani mambo yanakupata tu. So personal discipline is key. And hii ina apply kwa wale ambao umeokoka na ambao hujaokoka. Discipline is very 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 key, right? Now, tunarudi kwa mazungumzo yetu ya leo.
Yes.
Now, I wanted to ask you something about loans. Yes. Nimekuja niwe labda niko na biashara yangu ama maybe I'm under a salary or something. Uh-huh. Na nimefika mahali kule ambako ninahisi sasa nime save and then I need a loan.
Yes.
And then nimekuja maybe nimeulizwa what is it for and then nime explain. Uh-huh. And it makes a lot of sense. Na inasemekana okay kulingana vile ambao tumeona your transaction here and there, nini this is the amount of money
you qualify
that you qualify yes. for. And of course I gladly accept. And then of course all those documents you ask for, uh-huh. and then I sign and that money inaweko kwenye account yangu. And of course now how I use it, it is kama nilikuja nikawadanganya, si bora mimi niwalipe. In case ifike mahali na sasa repayment, and especially for someone who owns a business,
yes.
ikuwe a bit tricky, ni level gani ikifika ndivyo sasa tunaanzaga kukimbizana?
Okay,
tukipelekananga kwa wanaitwaje wale?
Auctioneers.
Kwa auctioneers na kurushana majina kwa ile kwa CRB. Inafikanga wapi hapo ndivyo tufike hapo?
Ndio tufike hapo.
Eh.
So ndio tufike hapo, acha tuanze mwanzo.
Anza hapo.
Tuanze mwanzo.
Anza.
Yes. Kama venye nilisema, we visit your business and get to understand your business.
Yes.
Umekuja umeleta makaratasi, tumeappraise, tumeona una qualify pesa fulani. Haishi hapo. Once I give you the money, I will also come and visit and see whether the money was used for the intended person, purpose.
Si wewe bora ulinipe pesa sasa, unanifuata nini?
Kama pesa nilikupatia working capital, Wilson, I'll come and visit the hardware. Ulinunua stock, because that's the way it's supposed to be done. As a relationship manager, I'm a banky. Not unless ikupendi. Na sisi kama bank tunapenda customers wetu. Not unless I am owning the business of lending. Right now nilisema banking is a personalized relationship. Ni okay. Kama relationship yenye unaanzisha na mtu. Yes. At UBA we make sure it's a personalized relationship. Si nikupe pesa utoke uende.
Okay.
The reason I'm saying that is because once I come and find out that nilikupea pesa umeweka working capital, that's okay. But pia kuna customers unapata ulimpea pesa ka divert akanunua plot na ile pesa ilikuwa ya working capital na ile plot yamenunua it's not generating income so ile plot haiwezi lipa loan
imekaa tu
bado ile duka yenye ilikuwa na stock yenye inataka kuongezwa ndio inatarajiwa ku so we start kabla tufike pale kwa auctioneer we start mending that hole
mess.
Mapema tunaanza ku rectify mapema. That's why nasema it's very important to have a post disbursement. Post disbursement namaanisha nini? After nimekupatia mkopo, it's very important nifuatilie mkopo yangu ama pesa yenye nimekupea ulitumia namna gani. Unaona? If it was used for the right reason, that is working capital. You get? So stock imekwa pale. One or two things can happen in between
sure.
As much as the stock has been put there.
100%.
Maybe mwenye nyumba amesema sasa wewe utabidi uhame ni renovate. You have to move there. Those are the ones we call unavoidable circumstances.
Okay.
So since it's a personalized relationship, it doesn't mean sasa nitakuangalia hivi nigoje 90 days ifike. Normally what happens, loan inakuanga na zile masiku zenye inatembea. We start with the first month in arrears, second month in arrears, nione uko notorious hata uwezi yeka hata 1 shilling or any amount. So it becomes now mahali na kupigia simu hushiki, the relationship is now becoming spoiled. You see, now it's the time we start moving the direction of the auctioneers. But us, as the bank I'm working with currently, what we do is we ensure that we work with you the journey. Why am I saying that? Umemovishwa to another building. We had agreed your installment would be 50,000, sindio? Umehama, bado kazi hijashika. You can currently afford 20,000. There is something we know we call loan restructures. Loan restructure inamaanisha aje? I can either give you a grace period. Si mimi naelewa. I can give you a grace period and agree, just pay the interest bit first. Because you see an installment is made up of interest and principal. Iko na vitu mbili. Kuna principal na interest. Because mimi nikikupea pesa, I'm in the business of making money for the people who have given me deposit. Because in the time of investment, the other people who invest in the bank by giving the bank money, na wao wanalipwa interest. This is the money we used to lend to the borrowers, now the SMEs. You get?
Yeah.
So in that, there is, if I gave you 500,000, you're supposed to return it as maybe 550,000. The 50,000 is the interest that you're paying to the bank, which now maybe will be divided. If you're paying the loan within 12 months, itakuwa imegawanishwa for the 12 months. So umebomolewa ama umehamishwa mahali kwingine. Don't run away from the bank. Kindly don't run away. Usijifiche.
Okay.
These things happen.
For sometimes, wezi kuwa chini ya maji.
No, don't. Because I will not understand. Your relationship manager, like I said, should know these things. That's why they make visits even after. Because unajua, the only way the relationship manager will find out kitu ilikuhapenia ni juu, he's keeping in touch with you.
Okay.
You're also free with them. Yani landlord leo ameniambia nataka nitoke. You're able to tell them freely. Not a robotic relationship, but mimi nitaweka tu pesa alone. Wewe nakuja nikikumalizia. Tarehe yako ni tano, unafaa kulipa 50,000 and then inaishia hapo. No. We go the extra mile of doing the...
So there's a relationship.
Yes. So okay. Then when ikifika hapo, unakuja tunaekelea kwa meza. Mimi nimehama kutoka hapa. Huyu landlord nilikuwa namlipa 50,000. Penye nimepata nalipa 60,000 ama 70,000. So cost yangu kuna venye imeenda juu. Unaona, sijapata customers bado, ndo najimarket ndo nipate customers, unaona. So we get to find out, sasa venye umehamia hapo, saa hii loan ulikuwa unafaa kulipa 50,000. Wewe saa hii ukijicheck, unaweza afford ngapi?
Siwezi, for now. Sindio,
okay. Siwezi for now. Okay, siwezi for now.
For now.
Unaona sasa tunakaa chini, we do our evaluation, huwezi for now. So what can we do? So ndio nilisema, unakumbuka time ya COVID? Most of the business were closed.
Unexpectedly.
Yes. That does not mean that sasa vitu zilifika mwisho. People came to the bank and banks were giving grace period to these people. There is something known as grace period. Grace period inamaanisha, in this duration, huyu mtu hajiwezi for 3 months, we can give them a grace period. After the 3 months, ataresume biashara.
Yeah, all right.
Yes, you come back and now start saying. That's why I said it's a relationship. And that's why I'm saying, even when you're being given a loan right now, they are called tailor-made loans. Tailor-made inamaanisha, siku hizi huwezi kuwa na loan specific, yani like a product yenye ni you share to everybody. It's tailor-made. What business are you doing? Because utapata kuna mtu akona shule, this school cannot pay a monthly installment. They do what? They pay a termly.
Okay.
So wazazi watalipa school fees, watu wakirudi shule,
yes.
That's a termly. You'll get someone who is in farming, this person can only pay you once he has harvested and sold the harvest.
So you have to wait.
So we agree. E loan nimechukua, I'll pay you after 6 months. You get?
Yeah.
There's a person who is doing an LPU, contract financing. Amepewa na Nakuru County to go and build some apartments, and he'll be paid after 6 months. Amepewa tender ya affordable housing. Those are the, now what I'm saying, tailor-made products. When you to agree,
right,
you'll pay these and these.
Okay.
So when it comes to a loan, not unless now things are very bad.
Yeah. Extreme.
Please don't run away from the bank.
Okay.
Yes. Have a sitting with them. Mimi hii na hii imenifanyikia. Nataka mnisaidie for this. I want a grace period for this. I want to pay 20, restructure, maybe increase the period. Because pia loan inakuwa na duration. So unaweza kuchukua na 12 months.
Yeah.
And maybe now that 12 months was squeezing the installment to 50. You can spread it to 18 months or 24 months to reduce the amount
so
that you are paying.
So zuri ni kuje tu, ni
tukae chini tusikizane.
Hivi, this is what has happened, na nini na nini.
Yes.
Okay, nikikuwa huyo mingine fani, huyo wakukata kuchukua na kujificha,
yes,
na nini, mlitumia auctioneers, wapata kuna kitu ya kuauction. How?
No, when you're giving a loan, okay, when you're giving a loan, utapata kuna either guarantors, either umetumia your stock, ama either umetumia title, umetumia logbook. Sometimes as a bank, you
there
need to have
to be
a fallback.
Yes, kuna security
a fallback,
flani.
Yes. Yeah. After akishindwa, what are we? Because pia unajua tunapenda pesa ya wenyewe. We need to have a fallback. If this one does not pay, what is our fallback?
So being an honest person is the best way.
Exactly. Integrity, like if we expect the people when you wako kwa bank wakue. Even when you're in business, you will only go very far and very successful if you have that integrity.
Wow.
Yes.
Now, I just love this. Leo nimesema tu niulize maswali zote from any angle, ndivyo kila mtu mwenye alikuwa amepanga kujificha ujue utafuata ushangae. Na si vizuri, just go there, just explain the circumstances under which umejipata uko in a very tricky situation. They will understand, ni watu tu, and then maybe they can restructure kama vile ambavyo tumeambiwa and all that, na kila kitu kiwe shwari kabisa. Now, wacha tukuje kwa online banking.
Yes.
First of all, kwa mtu ama tu nini kwanza? Wacha tu niulize hii alafu sasa tuende kwa watu, because najua hiyo time nayo. Online banking, wakati ambapo tunaongea about online banking, what are you really talking about?
So online banking, you'll get that some people are very busy in their businesses. Hata wakati ya kukuja bank
hana.
Yes. So we call them online banking, and we also call them digital banking platforms. Okay, wacha wale wenye wanaambiwa bank online. There are some people who come and say we want to start an online bank. I'm an online something fishy. But now what I'm talking with about is mimi mwenye siwezi fika bank, how can I access my account or my money when I'm
kwenye
na si kutoa tu, ni pia kuweka. It happens both ways.
Yes,
eh?
Yes,
accessing
yes.
online. Eh? So for example, mutu wako, we go to the hardware person. I think it was a very good example. These people are very busy, hana time ya kukuja bank. So we give them a solution on how they can bank, their clients can bank without them coming to queue in the banking hall.
Physically.
Yes.
Okay.
And they're also able to withdraw the money. Because you see, a bank account is whereby you do transactions. You either withdraw, you either deposit, you either pay checks. Because you know we have accounts that have checkbooks. So mutu analipa mutu, you just draw a check and pay. So for the online banking, these are now the digital platforms. So as a bank, as UBA, we have very good digital platforms whereby we have kitu inaitwa internet banking. Internet banking, as a business person, you have your own laptop or a very good phone. You are able to access your account at the comfort of your office.
Yes.
Whereby we give you credentials, we make sure this is a very safe platform. There's something known as OTP. You can only access if you have that code. So for example, you are Wilson and maybe someone is trying to get into your internet banking. You will be notified someone is trying. So if you're not the one, you're able to warn the bank someone is trying to access my account.
That's not me.
Yes. And we're able to block any person trying to access your account. So for the internet banking, you are able to even pull your statements from that internet banking. You're able to see how many transactions ama how many checks. For example, the busy people wanakuwa wana check mbili tatu ine. So you're able to see in the morning checks zinakonganga asubuhi. You're able to see these and these checks have come to my account. I'm supposed to fund the account so that the checks can go through. So you're comfortably able to see your account. You can even comfortably transfer money to another bank. And you can also pay salaries, because you get someone who has a lot of people who are working for them.
Yeah.
They tengeneza an Excel. This may be the people working there. They don't hold account with the same bank that they wewe uko bank ingine yako ingine, it's a list of people. Okay. So there's a way that internet banking, you can come up with an Excel and you're able to push money to their various
bank accounts,
even M-Pesa. So we have a very good digital platform. Right. And the good thing with it is a maker checker. Maker checker how? Someone makes, another one checks. Because we call it dual control to avoid any inefficiency.
So is it safe?
It's very safe. Because now you're having someone who is going through the list of what has been done. And before the money is sent, there is another person who is authenticating the transaction.
Okay.
Yes. And there is another person receiving the OTP to authorize. So the reason it has these stages, utapata mtu mko na vitu mingi mnataka nifanye, but the reason we are doing that is we have someone who is making sure the money. Unajua wewe ukishikwa saa hii, and then you are the maker, hata wakufanyie nini, if the checker has not authorized, that money cannot
cannot go anywhere.
That's why we are saying maker checker. It ensures that there is always protection before the money goes out. And that's why I say even before accessing, we ensure that you get an OTP to notify you.
Okay.
So after you get the OTP, you're the ones to authorize. Now with that keying in the OTP there, you're able to do that. All that's right. Internet banking.
Okay.
Now we have the other platforms. These are the ATM cards and also the mobile banking. For UBA, we have a very good platform known as Leo. You're able to transact via WhatsApp. So you're someone, umetoka mahali kujivinjari kidogo, then mtu anakupiga geta. So the way people think is that you have various application. You kuna app ya NCBA tu apps tuko hapo. Unaambiwa finya hapa tuone unaweza qualify ngapi. For this one it's a bit good and I find it very okay because hii ni kwa WhatsApp. You are able to transact through the WhatsApp platform. So kabla mtu afikirie, yes. So how it operates, you're able to talk with a bank representative through that WhatsApp. So kabla mtu afikirie unaweza toa pesa na WhatsApp, unajua that will be the last resort.
Yeah.
So we have very good platforms whereby we are able to do online banking for these customers.
Okay.
Yes.
So it's a safe platform and all that.
Exactly.
How easy is it now that tuko kwa area digital literacy and all that?
Yes.
For anyone to hack system, your bank.
Yes.
How possible is that?
It's not as people say it. It's not as easy as that. Because we have a whole department with very many staff. Under IT, under control, fraud, anything. We have a very dedicated team, 24/7.
So any attempt
exactly. Not unless you do it the way I told you.
Yeah.
It comes from your end. But if it comes through the bank, which is very hardly comes through the bank, we have very good controlled systems whereby even us as a staff, it's very hard for you to get money from hata wewe mwenye uko ndani ya hiyo bank. It's very hard for you to access a customer's funds.
It's highly controlled.
Exactly.
Now, okay, tuliongea na watu about what we call choosing kusave kwa banki ama kusave pale nyumbani, na kuna baadhi ya maoni ambayo unataka usikize as you comment kwa mengine hapo, and I believe ya kwamba kila kitu kitakuwa ni shwari kabisa. Na kama una swali kama vile ambavyo nilikuwa nimekutaarifu tukianza kipindi hiki, 0721 105 105, ukituma ujumbe hapo nitausoma, na pia 23814 na kila kitu kitakuwa kiko sawa kabisa. Kumbuka tuko live kwenye Facebook MBC TV, na tuko live kwenye YouTube MBC TV official YouTube channel, na kila kitu kiko shwari kabisa. Nafikiri kwamba walikuwa ni watu saba, kwa hiyo tutafanya 4 and then 3. Yes, tusikie baadhi ya maoni, tupate sauti huku, ndivyo tujue mbona yule ambaye ana prefer kuweka kwenye benki ana prefer, na yule ambaye anasema naweka kwa nyumba mbona pia naye ana prefer hivyo. Maoni ndio haya.
Tunapohifadhi pesa, mara mingi nimejaribu kuhifadhi pesa kwa mkepe nikiweka kwa nyumba, lakini unapokuwa na hiyo pesa mara mingi tunakuwa na changamoto sana. Kwa hivyo ninaona najaribu kufanya kuadhalisha ya kwamba ukitaka kusave pesa vizuri, weka katika benki. Kwa sababu unapoweka kwa benki na uweke mahali pa lock saving account ya kwamba nitatumia hii pesa baada ya muda fulani, hiyo pesa hautaweza kwenda kwa benki kuitoa kwa urahisi. Lakini ukiweka pesa yako ya kwamba unasema ninachisavia pesa either kwa simu ama unaichisavia pesa kwa mkepa, hautaweza kuwa na pesa. Hiyo pesa utatumia.
Mimi naona ni poa kuweka kwa nyumba juu angalau unaiona. Unajua sasa zingine saizi bank hata imekuwa risky, saa zingine unapigiwa simu na watu wengine wanakuuliza mambo ya pin nini. So ukikuwa uko sharp sana, uko unapeana information, unaweza pata pesa yako hakuna. So saizi wakoro wamekuwa wame advance mpaka unaogopa bank. So unaona afadhali saa zingine unaiona pale. Nyumba ikiungua hiyo zinaitwa emergency, inaitwa accidents. Yaani sasa hiyo hatuombi hiyo. Tunaomba mazuri, lakini saizi vile shida iko, nikiweka pesa kwa nyumba hata iwezi kaa kwa nyumba, atakuwa tu naitubianga mdogo mdogo kabla ichomeke itakaye baki kidogo.
Kwa bank ni safe. Kwa nyumba I think utakufanya tu impulse buying. Hiyo pesa utatoa toa bila sababu. So ikiwa kwa bank mimi naona ni better. Juu kabla ufikirie kutoka kwenda kwa bank ni process.
Kuweka pesa kwa bank ni mzuri kwa sababu pesa zako ziko safe.
Kuweka pesa kwa nyumba ni poa kwa sababu ukiweka pesa kwa nyumba uko sure tu inaweza kusaidia masaa yoyote. Huwezi zipata, lakini si ukipata tu hiyo hasara ya siku moja, huwezi si ati utapata hasara ya kila wakati, utavumilia tu cause hizo pesa umeziekanga tu kwa nyumba zikusaidie. Kwa banki sidhani kazi zinaweza kusaidia venye nataka.
Okay. Where do people feel like pesa yako iko kwenye benki, hawezi access venye unataka na hawezi tumia venye unataka, so you'd rather keep it in the house. Mm-hmm. Pale ambapo ukifanya tu hivi unaiona.
So ni ukweli Kenya amesema, lakini naona hapo ni kukosa hiyo information ama banki yake haijamfuatilia imuzie hizo products online. Mm-hmm. Kwa sasa hivi tumekaa na wewe Wilson. Sasa hata uniuzie kitu hapa nikataka kukulipa na pesa yiko kwa bank.
Utalipa.
Na kulipa sasa hivi. Mm. So I think ni kukosa hiyo information.
Mm-hmm.
Cause online banking is very accessible.
Yeah.
Mobile banking is very perfect right now. Hata
yeah.
Kama ni mzigo nimeambiwa mzigo wangu umeshukishwa mahali, lipa bank ya Ndem Bank ama lipa bank ya UBA, I can easily transfer money from the account where the money is to that.
Yeah.
And it's instant.
Yeah.
Like sasa hivi tumekaa hivi na nakuonyesha information.
Mm.
So hiyo kufeel na the good thing saa hii hata mama wa kibanda utapata wako na a way you can pay them with money from your account.
Sure.
Yani watu wameelimika, uwezi sema nitaenda kununua kabejaji kama sina pesa.
Mm-hmm.
Kwa physical cash.
Mm-hmm.
You can. Mimi nikienda kwa mama wangu hapo karibu na mwambia nataka nyanya hizi na hizi na hizi, I can easily pay her.
Yeah.
Online.
Yeah.
So I think in lack of information.
Okay.
We should, as bankers, we should really go to these people and educate
them. Understand.
Exactly.
And of course kuna yule mwenye amesema kwamba siku hizi kuna mambo mengi.
Mm.
Maana unasikia kuna hackers, I don't know what.
Yes.
I think pia alikuwa na touch on something that you had really talked about.
Yes.
That hiyo ndio inafanya mtu anaona ya kwamba ni kama kwa banks
pesa. Si, lakini kitu mzuri umesikia amesema nini? Kama wewe si sharp utajipata umebonyeza.
Mm.
Most of the time it comes from wewe mwenye account wendu na you give out the information. Now
yeah.
That's why I'm insisting. Find out who is calling you. Si kila mtu anafaa kukupigia.
Mm.
Kindly hata wale wenye wako mashinani. Si kila mtu anafaa kukupigia. Simu siku hizi watu, kuna watu wako na simu kama 20. Si watu walishika wako na very many phones.
So,
kazi tu ni kupiga.
Mm.
So don't be called by anybody to transfer money. Money is a sensitive information.
Yeah.
Money is a sensitive ground. Wezi nipigia tu tuma hivi na hivi. Ask questions. Don't even engage them.
Mm.
Yes, kama si bug, kama si mtu tunajua, cut them off.
There's this other thing I know also the viewer has heard about it. And of course, lazima umeisikia. Whereby,
yes.
Unasikia kule kwenye mtaa mtu anasema ya kwamba, you see, siniloni unataka kwa bank.
Yes.
This is what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Unaenda tu unaweka pesa. Sibora wameone mingia, toa.
Mm-hmm.
We tumia, ukipata ingine, we pitishia tu huku. Bora wane kuna, alafu sasa ukienda, uta qualify for, how does that one, is it true or how
it happens.
It okay.
Most of the banks tutasikia kisema window dressing, Yenye unataka pesa ingi kitoka, pesa ingi kitoka.
Hata ipumziki.
Hata ipumziki.
Kama ndio hiyo tena.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Na kuna kitu inaitwa account analysis, Unajua wataalamu pia wenye wanapeana loan, the analyst, can easily pick that out. Yani mtu aliniwekea 1200, 30 minutes afterwards ame withdraw cash. You know there is a payment. Alafu siku hizi ukifanya transaction it narrates.
Oh.
Yes, money
okay.
Has been paid to a guy for purchase of this and this.
Uh-huh.
There is narration. So you can easily see what the money has been. So wale wakufanya window dressing, we really pick them easily. Huyu amekuwa ki window dress for this reason. So what we can do, we can be, because kuna pia watu wana, you get some people also buying float nini nini. We are able to tell the turnovers. We are able to, we have been trained on that. our people have been trained, various banks have trained people on that. Mm-hmm. As UBA, we have been able to get analysts who can tell this is the money that, at the end of it all, as much as amekuwa kieka akitoa, what was retained? Kuna kitu inaitwa retention.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So what is the retention of this account? Mm. Exactly.
So kama iko sawa.
Si kuweka tu kutoa, it's also the retention of the account. Yes.
All right.
Yes.
So when it comes to saving money in a bank, does it even help in discipline in terms of how, you know, I perceive money and all that?
Yes.
How?
Because that lady has really said, when you put money in the bank, it avoids impulse buying. It, okay, for example, when you have, you know, we have different accounts. In UBA, we have very different accounts. We have a savings account. We have accounts that we don't necessarily give you a mobile banking. Why?
Mm.
This is a savings account. Siki tunafaa kwa kilipalipa.
Uko nje.
Yes. So there are different accounts. Utakuja uniambia, I want a savings account. Mm-hmm. I want to lock my money here.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are locking the amount, it means that it's not easily accessible. So you can have two, whereby you can easily access the money and one that you lock your savings.
Okay.
So when they say it's safe to put the money in the bank, you can even say, I have this account that I want to be pushing 30,000 every month. And I don't want a mobile banking. And then give me another account whereby I can use for my own expenses.
Mm.
So we have savings account, and the good thing, if you're able to open with the right bank like UBA, we give you interest on that money, because
okay,
it's locked money.
Mm.
So we give very, very good competitive rates for that money that you have fixed.
All right.
So you can come and tell me this is an amount of a million, I want it to stay for 3 months.
Okay.
I'll give you a good rate for that.
All right.
Yes.
Swalini, mm-hmm, if I have my money with you people.
Yes.
Name is safe kwenye bank.
Yes.
And it's not specifically UBA but any other banking institution.
Yes.
Si kuna pesa zangu huko.
Okay.
Na nime save.
Yeah.
Sasa kama savings account. Kuna charges za monthly or something?
No. When you save money, that's a savings account.
Okay.
You only deducted money for a business account. You see, a business account is whereby you are transacting
money.
You have a checkbook, we call you to confirm this check. So you get some accounts in different banks, hold some maintenance fee.
Mm-hmm.
But a savings account is not an expensive account. That's where you save your money.
Mm-hmm.
If you deposited a million, you'll find it as a million or has increased. You can only earn from that account because
okay,
it's a savings account, not being deducted on that savings account.
Mm.
The only time you'll be deducted is when 3 months imeisha nilikuwa naweka hii pesa for a certain reason, which is buying a plot or buying something, sasa nataka withdraw.
When you say it has increased for savings account,
you will get, you open a savings account with us,
yes,
you have deposited a million,
mm-hmm,
you don't want to use this money.
Mm-hmm.
And me, as UB, I don't want you to take that money somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll give you an interest rate on that account.
Mm-hmm.
You get? Because your money should be making some, you what, investing in a bank, like I said, you can also invest in this way.
Yeah.
You can have a fixed deposit. We call it a fixed deposit, whereby you have some money somewhere, you want to come and fix it at the bank.
Yeah.
So you say, I want you to stay with this 2 million for 6 months.
Mm.
So we negotiate for you an interest rate, just like we do for loans.
Mm-hmm.
We also pay you on that money staying in that account.
Mm.
Yes.
And that money can be used for some other reasons, uko, as long as nikitaka my 2M niipate.
Yeah, you utaipata hapo.
Those are the two. I think there are around 3 people. What is their take,
mm-hmm,
when it comes to saving money kwenye benki ama kuweka pesa kule nyumbani, and then kutoka hapo tusikie wana maoni gani.
Mimi nakaa kwa nyumba sababu shida ikitokea ni kuichukua na kuondoka. Nilikaa kwa banga, kuna time naweza kuwa nimechukua. Inazaleta njaa anytime. Akiiba, hata jua kafuli ni ngapi, nikaa kafuli mbili. Mm. Akifungua ya kwanza ingine na baki.
Hey, nikikufa nani ataenda kutoa kwa bank? Sasa afadhali tu niweke kwa nyumba. At least watu wanaweza tumia kama na kuweka kwa nyumba tena ni at least juu. Ukipatwa na emergency yote, ni rahisi kuchukua. Nyumba ikichomeka naye hapo itakuwa ngumu kidogo. Tutafanyaje, itakubali tu
kuweka kwa bank.
Kwa nini?
Mazo kuweka kwa bank utabaki na pesa za save, na bado unaweza kupatiwa mkopo ya simu, na bado unaweza kununua kitu kubwa kama shamba, kama unaweza kununua mali ujenge mali pazuri na uweke matunda, miti uweke, yani uko na kwako, yani kuliko uishi nyumba ya kukodesha. Ni mzuri kwa bank kuliko kwa nyumba. Nyumba unaweza bomoa anytime kama uwezo wapita naye.
Okay, kundi lingine la wale ambao wanahisi ya kwamba kuna mmoja ambaye amesema kwamba ni vizuri kuweka kwenye benki, lakini kuna mwingine mpaka anasema anahofia akifa nani watatumia hizo pesa? You know,
yes.
And maybe it's good. Unajua sasa haya anakuambia perception ambayo iko kwenye jamii wakati mwingine kwa watu ambao hawana enough information. For example, when it comes now to like that unfortunate incident,
yes,
whereby nime save and then my time to kulefti group ya huku duniani imefika and I'm gone.
Okay.
How does that go?
When you're opening an account, there's a very important part when you're opening an account,
yeah,
known as the next of kin.
Yes.
So when you're opening an account, we ask for the next of kin information.
Mm-hmm.
That's the information now you, when you're not there, that's the person now we can easily contact. You get people putting their kids, their spouses, mm-hmm, for easy contact for the bank.
In case
of anything.
Okay.
So I think that's the education that most of these people don't get.
Mm.
So when you put a next of kin, in case of a demise, we have not been able to see this customer for some time, or we are able to find out, we'll need a death certificate and all that to freeze that account, meaning nobody can access that money until you get a letter from, we also work with the government.
Okay.
Most of the time we work with the government. We just don't release money because you have come, you are the next of kin. No.
Mm.
There's a procedure that is followed.
Has to be followed.
Yes, a legal procedure that goes through some of the respective offices, and they come down and sit and give us a letter.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time you'll get money for the deceased is transferred to that those various offices for them now to decide who are the rightful owners. Because
okay,
they might know those people more than the bank might know.
All right.
But the reason for the next of kin that we hold is to get this information that we're able to act accordingly.
Is it possible for someone to come and say, I want to open an account with you people and sitaki mambo ya next of kin?
No, we can't open that account. An account should
mimi
have.
Nimekuja.
No, umekuja, yes. But
nimewaletea.
In case unataka. You know, when you want to avoid a future error, always rectify from the word go. Always deal with always deal with it. So it's good to have the right information from the word go. To avoid any drama.
Yeah. So if someone comes and they don't...
Nobody really can lack a next of kin.
Na kama yeye ndiye atakaye ndakati ya kuwe na a secret account.
No, what we do with that person, when they are coming with that perspective, we educate them.
Mm-hmm.
We don't just tell them lazima ukuwe na next. We tell them the reason why you need to have a next of kin. And Wilson, by the time I'm finished explaining the reason for that next of kin, that customer will be very happy.
Okay.
Yes, because so most of the time we lack. Yani anadhani ukiweka next of kin, huu next of kin atakuja achukue pesa yangu, atakuja afanye nini. No, we educate them on the reason for next of kin and the reason for that next of kin.
Other than death, kuna any other reason?
Yes, you can have a customer maybe he has gone outside the country, he's not able to get rich of the bank,
mm-hmm,
he sends the next of kin to come and get maybe hold of us. Mm-hmm. Maybe there is a story of the loan, we need information, hatupati mutu, we call the next of kin. It's a two-way traffic. The next of kin can be an assistance to us as the bank and also an assistance to them.
Mm-hmm.
So if we are not able to get hold of that client, we can always use the next of kin number to try and get what happened.
Okay.
You will get that the next of kin is someone that communicates with this person. So if there is a new change of number, the next of kin is the one who can easily tell us. So it's a two-way traffic.
What if I just picked a name?
As next of kin?
Yeah. Nikasema tu, oh, mnataka next of kin, so and so.
Yeah.
And then, ninajua kabisa, hata hakuna mtu kama huyo.
Mm-hmm.
And then after some time, God decides it's your time to come.
No, we confirm the next of kin.
How will you confirm now?
You know, when you are coming to us and sharing the next of kin, it's not just a name.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Okay.
It's also with a phone number.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
So.
And other documentation for that next of kin.
And of course, if I try kutumia ujanja, it's to my own disadvantage.
Yes, exactly.
In case of something, because sasa, hata kumikuwa wakati mwingine unasikia ati kuna mtu alikuwa amejenga mahali hakusema. So akienda, hakuna mtu.
Mtu anajua.
You know, I think that is why we end up having unclaimed assets.
Yes. Because once now, even right now, once account is dormant, umeacha kutumia, you don't find out mawia. Us, we are regulated to transfer the funds to the unclaimed assets. Then you are the one now to follow up. In case you find out, you follow up with unclaimed assets.
Okay.
Yes.
But sasa it's kwamba this institution kama imeona hii imekuwa dormant,
yes,
ina pesa ndani, hakuna mtu anakujianga for how long do you now
It depends with the various institutions, so we have various timelines for different institutions, so that one is not generalized for every institution.
Oh, so every institution iko na nini zake.
Yeah.
So you transfer there, so hiyo kesi inatoka kwenye mikono yenu kabisa.
Yes.
Kabisa.
Now when he wants to claim, ama the next of kin and everybody wants to claim, now they go through the channel of the unclaimed assets.
Yes. There you go. So banking is you know, learning how to save in a bank is very important, but also knowing what I need to do in terms of, you know, loan repayment and all that is also very key. And also you have highlighted that issue of online banking, that it is really safe.
Yes.
Because sometimes people have fear that ukiweka hapo, I don't know who is going to nini na nini na nini. And maybe, I don't know what you'll say. Now, generally in terms of saving in a bank, as far as now someone who is in business, a salaried person or whoever is concerned.
Okay. So I think to sum it all, it is very important to save with the bank for the various reasons that we have mentioned. For an SME, it's very essential for them to save the bank, because it afika mahali you'll need the bank to come and support you financially. For example, I want to mention something with UBA, United Bank of Africa. We have very good products. Very good products. For example, I'm a person in business, a lady in business. Kwanza, we are really supporting those ladies that are in business.
Okay.
So you get that the ladies in business, women-led businesses, we are calling them women-led businesses, they're able to access very good loans at discounted interest rates for women-led businesses. And if you don't have enough security, for example, I want a loan of 1 million. The land that I have, inaweza nisimamia tu 500,000. So we have partnered with very good guarantees. Guarantees inamaanishaje? People who come up want to support SMEs. So mimi security yangu inaweza tosha kunisimamia 500 and I want a million. So we get some guarantees that will come in and support the other balance. So instead of you taking less money because security yako haiwezi tosha, you are able to take the enough money that will assist your business. So we have things like AGF.
Okay.
Yes, African Guarantee Fund. It's a fund, an African fund, whereby they assist people in business. Because you see, when you're dealing with MSMEs, these are small, medium, micro enterprises, yes? Right. So these are people who are, ni watu wanajilea. Si mtu anatarajia kuna eka 20 za shamba. Sahi ndio anajilea ndo anunue hiyo eka. So African Guarantee comes in to support them so that they reach mahali sasa wanaweza jisimamia na collateral zao.
Okay.
But for now, they come in and support these people. So the only way you can access AGF, ni kama una bank na bank. Because if you're putting your money at home, AGF doesn't know you. They only know you through that bank that you're banking with. So UBA, we have partnered with these different people to be able to help SMEs. Why SMEs? Right now, SMEs are the ones who are driving this economy. SMEs are the ones who are creating employment for our people. So there's a reason to go the SME way. You support the SME, you support the whole economy. Because SME is whereby we get the supplier and the all the people, even manufacturers. Unapata mtu akona ka manufacturing kake kadogo ka sabuni. If you help them, they will create employment and they will also improve the livelihood of where they are living.
Sure.
So SME is a critical part where us as United Bank for Africa, we have decided to go the SME way to help these people. And we are making it very easy.
Okay.
Because we are tailor making a product for them. Mtu anatengeneza sabuni, we tailor make a product for them.
Okay.
And if the security is not enough, you're able to come up and support them.
Yeah.
For the salary people also, when you are banking with a bank, anything can happen. Mtoto anaweza kuwa mgonjwa, God forbid, ama something happens. I need money instantly. I need an advance. If you are salaried people listening to me, those who are taking salary advance, they can attest to how important that thing is. Because utaki kusumbwana na employer wako, washinange akijua mashida zenye niko nazo. A bank, we are open. We don't even want to find out a lot more what you're doing with the money as long as you are under your payroll.
Okay.
You see? So you're able to be financially independent with your bank instead of borrowing with umepigia auntie, umepigia nani. The bank comes in to remove that shame of you calling so many people. So when you're banking with a bank, you're able to work. UBA is able to work with you. You as an employee, you as an SME.
Yeah.
Na pia tuko na wale wako na pesa who want to fix.
Okay.
We have also people who have money, they are trying to invest that money.
Right.
So they can also invest with the bank so that we're able to help those who don't have.
Okay.
So we pay them a certain percentage and we're able to lend this money to other people.
I wanted to ask you a question.
Yes.
Someone has come to me and take a loan with a banking institution.
Yes.
Nataka nikuwe guarantor. Kwa sababu hapo pia kuna mambo.
Yes.
si in case huyo jamaa ama that lady asipoona nini yake nitatafutwa hata mimi.
That's the reason for a guarantor.
So,
as short as that.
Before, mimi mnanitafuta nifanye nini?
No, when you are guaranteeing that person, a guarantorship, hiyo guarantorship inasomanga aji. In case asipolipa hii loan, mimi kama Wilson, na mkuampa kuwa, you are guaranteeing that person. But before we reach to you, we'll have exhausted all the other. We will have exhausted all the other channels of getting.
So mkinifikia mnanifikia mkinifikia mnanifikia nilipe.
Eh, kama guarantor.
So what do I need to consider before I accept?
Now, before you guarantee someone, you should know that person. Na hata the moment umemguarantee unafaa ujichukulie ni kama mmechukua loan hiyo wote wawili. The moment umeguarantee mtu hivi, si umeweka kidole. You should be our watchdog. Na ujue Petronila ile loan ni kuguarantee mtu naona akienda hivi na hivi. You warn us.
Mm-hmm.
When you walk with a journey with them, because ulikubali kuwa guarantee ni mtu unajua, because Wilson huwezi guarantee tu mtu atijua
ati na kama wenye watu wanafanyanga maybe ya colleague na mgarantee alafu kidogo kidogo ametoka kwa hiyo kampuni ameenda alafu unaanza kusikia ati anafuata unashindwa sasa mimi mnaniuliza nini na tulikuwa tunafanya
kwanza guarantee for salaries we are co-guaranteeing each other and we are employed in the same institution. In case that person leaves, you see your salary is also passing with us. And the reason for the major reason for a guarantor is to ensure that he assists us in recovering that loan.
Yeah.
Yes. You are so like a collateral to that facility.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So si ku guarantee mtu ananyamaza tu lazima nifuatilie nijue
yes.
Kama anafanya.
Yes. Ndio nimesema ni kama mmechukua hiyo loan pamoja.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now you know if you come to me and then if nime invest pesa nimewekeza pesa na banki fulani then inafika mahali I just don't want anything to do with this bank.
Mm-hmm.
Ikifika ni wakati nimesema sasa mimi nataka kuchange pesa zangu ambazo niko hapa nataka kuzipeleka kwa another banking institution.
Yes.
Kuna kuvutana tutavutana nyinyi?
No, you are right, you have your right to your money.
How does
you
that now the right process to your goes money. Until sasa?
So until ifike hapo, okay, I would want to understand. Kwanza unakumbuka nilisema mimi ni team leader.
Mm-hmm.
So nisikia umetaka kutoa pesa na labda nilikuwa nimekupatia Sara kama relationship manager, I would want to find out who customer kwa nini anataka kutoa pesa, what happens between the salesperson yenye nilimpatia.
Mm-hmm.
Unaona? So I find out more before ifike hapo. But mm-hmm. a customer is entitled to their own funds.
Okay.
So if a customer really wants to transfer that funds, maybe for the purpose of amesave, imetosha, anataka kununua shamba, na mwenye analipwa shamba hana account kwenye wewe uko na account.
Mm-hmm.
Si pesa ulikuwa umewekeza na mimi, UBA bank, na maybe mwenye analipwa ako Equity bank or somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
I can maybe try reach out to him and also bank him, but if he's not willing to come, he has a bank, we easily transfer the money to where you are purchasing. A customer has the right to access their funds.
Yeah.
At the given time, because we didn't take the money to stay with it.
Mm.
It's yours.
So even if I want to close, you know, account yenye niko nayo na nyinyi kabisa, but just transfer my money to this account.
Yes.
You are going to do it.
Yes, there's an account closure form for the bank, whereby if you want to close an account, you fill that account closure form. These are instructions given to us by a customer, and you should always follow a customer's instructions.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Does it have like, now that you have decided to do this, we are going to deduct this amount or something?
No.
So kama ni 2M, itaenda hivyo.
Yes, the only charge is the withdrawal charge or anything.
Yeah, like
but we are tutasema now that we umetoroka, we are, now that you spoke, because you know, me what I believe in, relationship is very important.
Very.
That customer might be withdrawing that money for now, but I'll need him later.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't live in a bad ground.
Mm.
As a bank and as a relationship kind of interaction, customer always lives as satisfied.
Yeah.
The customer is the king. The customer is the one who's making me to be there.
Mm.
Whatever the customer wants is what we do.
Mm.
And I need this customer again. That's not the end of the business.
Okay.
So we keep that relationship.
Is it possible for someone kuwa anawekeza hela kwenye benki fulani?
Yes.
Lakini pia akiangaliwa hivi anaonekana kwamba huyu kumpea loan itakuwa ni kujiweka kwenye mtego.
Yes, kuna kitu inaitwa CRB. Right now CRB nasema wewe uko na loan Family Bank. Yes, uko na loan Family Bank, ume default for 4 months.
Na uko.
Yeah. Then you are approaching another bank for a facility. For us, to be able to find information, we check the CRB.
Mm-hmm.
If you are listed, it doesn't mean we won't give you the loan. We tell you go and sort your issues with this bank. They have listed you on CRB on this and this and this. Kindly sort liars with them, then we can proceed with the other applications.
So even if my account here is really
yes, CRB is a very essential tool when you are praising a customer. Because you see what, Wilson, that's a character issue. Why would you be having a very good account here and you're not paying somewhere else? Not unless you make me understand. Maybe hapa na hapa, ilikuwa hapa nivi. We get now, like I said, a bank is not only lending. We get to sit down and understand each other. Mm. Then I find out what happened. I can even advise you on how we are going to clear that facility, mm-hmm. on how we are going to pay that facility. I'm also should be your financial guide.
Yeah.
Because I have been told by the bank on how I should financially advise mm-hmm. you. So we sit down and find out what was the reason for the listing, how can we come out from the negative listing, and we move forward. And now right now CRB does not only do negative listing, it also do positive listing. Mm-hmm. By that it means you as Wilson, CRB will show all the loans that you're having and they are performing. Because we have performing and non-performing facilities.
Yeah.
So we're able to tell from that information. Because like I said, you can have a hardware and you are paying 50,000 for a loan somewhere else. That's mm-hmm. your profit margin, mm-hmm. you see? So mm-hmm. I'm able to see you are paying 50,000 there. Mm-hmm. The only headroom you have is maybe to pay an extra 20,000.
Yeah.
If I don't have that information that you have another loan somewhere else, I might end up over-financing you and messing you.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the thing I said, we work together and we financially advise
okay.
the clients.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, as we tukwenda gangapi, hii lazima tuiguzie, as tukwenda dakika kama tano hivi. Let's talk about these loan apps.
Yes.
You know, I just wanted to ask just like a question too. When you're talking about it, because sometimes unapata msee akona simu kama hii, lakini ukiingia kwenye simu yake, unapata zote ni loan apps, amechukua hapa, akona hii, akona hii, akona hii. And because inaonekana kana kwamba is very easy to access this money, so atachukua hapa, alafu akiona huku kumeumana, anachukua pale, then by the end of the day, unapata kwamba huyu mtu anadaiwa na karibu 10 loan apps, na zote hakuna yenye amelipa nini. So sometimes inafika mahali mpaka unajiuliza, do they do more harm than good, or how, you know?
There's something you touched on financial discipline.
Yeah.
You touched on financial discipline. You see these loans on the app, and the app, some of them are not even under, because you get, banks are mostly regulated by central bank.
Yes.
So you get this one, this other app, I don't want to mention because they're also being run by people. You get that you easily access the money, but what do you use the money to? You know, when you are borrowing money, you need to understand how you're going to pay that money. So someone can only access the money, go have fun, and they don't have a way of paying. And the good thing I find, it's good to borrow with a bank, they're able to evaluate how you're going to pay that money. For an app, might not be able to evaluate how you're going to pay that money.
Yeah.
So a bank is the right place to take a loan, because they will jua, hii biashara inaweza lipa kiwango fulani. So wacha tumpatie kiwango fulani. Something else can give you so much money and you're not able to pay that. So you get yourself in a mess, whereby you're taking this loan to pay this one. You're taking this to pay this. So you get yourself in a crisis or in a mess. So it's good also to have this education. And that's what I always am insisting again, working with these customers and kuwapea hiyo elimu on how they should manage their finances. Management of finances is very important. It's the very important thing.
Okay.
Yes.
So as we wind up, what would be your parting shot? And also to tell us, if someone wants to talk to you, how they can go about it.
Okay.
Yes.
So I want to appreciate for the chance you have given us here.
Welcome.
And I really want to take this opportunity to welcome Ama to talk about United Bank for Africa. I feel that we have very good products under MSMEs.
All right.
And I would really encourage, if you are a business person, mostly in Nakuru, now that we are situated in Nakuru, kindly approach our branch.
All right.
Let us sit with you. It's not necessarily you come and we give you a loan instantly. We will educate you and we'll come and visit your business and see what you are doing.
Okay.
So we are very transparent bank. We work with you with the journey. Okay. We tell you what we are offering. That's what we do.
All right.
We don't want to find a place where we are giving you false hopes. We give you tailor-made products like I mentioned. We give you a dedicated RM who will work with you. So if you get a time, we are located in Vickers House. That is along Kenyatta
Avenue.
Kenyatta Avenue. Past Caritas, you'll get us there.
Okay.
So we have Vickers House.
Yeah.
Yes, at the corner.
pale.
After, oh, yes.
Okay.
Kenyatta Avenue.
All right.
So I'm going also to share my contact.
Okay.
So that if someone would want to reach out to me,
yeah.
I don't mind. This is my personal number.
Okay.
I'm here. It's a passion I have,
yeah.
To see people. Ulimwanzishia na biashara ya 50,000. Now it's a million capital.
Okay.
So my number is 0710.
0710.
52.
52.
80. 80. 94.
94.
Petronila. So call me, give a call,
yeah.
And I will give you any financial information and guide you on what we are offering as United Bank of Africa. 0710
okay.
52 8094.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Tumeshukuru sana kwako kuweza kuja na nafurahi kwamba tutapata wakati mwingine kujadili masuala ya kifedha. Masuala
yes.
ya kifedha ni it's a very wide topic.
Exactly.
So hatuwezi kuimaliza in 1.5 hours.
City.
So ninajua kwamba we are going to find some other time and we'll invite you to come and talk more
yes.
on this issue.
Okay.
Because tunataka pia kama venye umesema ni vizuri wakati watu wana succeed katika you know all the aspects of life.
Yes.
Kama ni kifedha, kama ni kiroho na mambo mengine yote haya
yeah.
because it's very very important.
Mm-hmm.
Now nimekuwa naye Petronila Wanjiko ambaye ndiye meneja katika tawi la Nakuru benki hii ya UBA Nakuru kama vile ambavyo amekueleza along Kenyatta Avenue and of course pia nambari hiyo ambayo amekupa ukiweza kupiga na kuuliza ushauri kuhusiana na matumizi ya kifedha ninaamini ya kwamba ataweza kukusaidia because it is very evident hata vile ambavyo ana explain issues here she's very passionate kwa hiyo ukimpigia simu ataweza kukusaidia kwa njia iliyo safi kabisa na mambo yote yawe shwari. Now, next week, that will be on Monday, wacha tukunywe mapema mapema, Mwenyezi Mungu akitujalia kituweka hai, tutakuwa tunaongea mambo yo preparing for retirement because usipende wakati utafika na lazima utaretire. Now, do you sit down and think about it? Hapo unasemanga tutavuka hilo daraja tukifika hapo. Alafu unamaliza unakwenda nyumbani kule mashambani huku kujenga huku kufanya lolote umeishi town miaka 40 hauna anything watu wanakuuliza guka yeah kwani uliishi town ulikuwa unafanya nini ate so we'll be talking about it that will be next week come is my name tukutane ndani ya karaushi wa kesho ndani ya relationship Tuesday maana ke upendo upendo utaingia tu na lazima retirement ikuwe tini juu ya age ama sometimes unafika mahali pale ambapo unasema kwamba I think this is enough let me just go and just have some rest so that is what we'll be talking about that will be next Monday otherwise come is my very good name enjoy the rest of your viewing kwaheri